Hello friends, in this video I will be helping you with how to convert this DFA into a regular expression or how to extract a regular expression from a given DFA using Arden's theorem. So I'll be helping you with this as fast as I can and as easy way as possible. So do watch the video till end. So first thing we need to see is how many number of states are there. There are four number of states, that is Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4, and I hope you can see all the incoming edge, that is the edges which are incoming, that is the arrow towards which. Okay, for Q1 the incoming edges Q2B and Q3A, and this is how we need to see the incoming edge. I hope you are good in that. And the third thing we have to see is which is our final state and initial state. So in this case our initial state is Q1, right, and our final state is also Q1. Now one thing you need to keep in mind, that you need to take out regular expression for those states which are your final state. Okay, if you have two final states, then you will take out two regular expression. If you have three, then you will take out three, and in this case you have only one, so you will take out regular expression for only one state, that is Q1. Okay, one more thing you need to keep in mind, that whichever is your initial state, you just need to add null to it. Okay, so now let's calculate for every state. Now we need to just, in first step we need to just see all the incoming edges towards a particular state. So let's start with Q1. Nothing different we have to do, only we have to see the incoming edges to all the states. Okay, so for Q1 the incoming edge is Q2B, right, and Q3A. So what we'll do is we'll add null, because it is an initial state and it is a rule of Arden's theorem. Okay, and your incoming edge is Q3A and Q2B, right, no other incoming edge. So this is our equation number one. Okay, now we'll do for Q2 state. Okay, for Q2 state, if we see the incoming edge, there is only one incoming edge, that is Q1A. So we'll write it like this, and we did not add null over here because it is not our initial state. We add null only to our initial state. Okay, now we'll do for the same for Q3. So on Q3 there is only one incoming edge, that is Q1B. So we'll write it as Q1B, and same thing we'll do for Q4 as well. Okay, so for Q4, 1H, 2H, 3H and 4H. So on Q4 we have four incoming edges, that is Q2A, Q3B, Q4A and Q4B. So we have our four equations over here. Now the next part contains, we need to see is our final state. Remember, our final state was Q1. So here we will find out regular expression only for state Q1, okay, no other state. So for Q1, what we'll do is we'll pick this equation which we find it before, and we'll put the values of Q3 and Q2 from the remaining equations. Okay, so for Q3 we'll get it as Q1B, and for Q2 we'll get it as Q1A. Okay, not a problem, we can put it, we can use it, right? So I just did that, you can see that, and I got my equation as null plus Q1BA and Q1AB. okay, nothing, I just inserted the values, okay, of Q2 and Q3 over here in the above equation, so the equation becomes only, you can say, linear, that contains state Q1 only. Okay, so once it became linear, I'll just try to simplify it. Okay, so what we'll do is null plus, and I took Q1 as common, and it will be BA plus AB, right, no problem over here. In the next step what we'll do is we'll match it with our Arden's theorem. So our Arden's theorem equation was R is equal to Q plus RP, right? So is the equation in form of that, if Q1 is our R and null is our Q, and again this is our R, and then this is our P, right? So we can write it in a form that is like R is equal to QP asterisk, right? This states Arden's theorem. So we can write it as QP asterisk, that is null, and BA plus AB asterisk. Any problem over here? I don't think so, any problem over here. I just replaced this equation with this equation. That is what Arden's theorem states, right? And because Q1 was final state, so I am finding only for Q1 over here. So this is our equation, this is our regular expression which we got, and now null multiplied with anything will be that thing. So we will just remove null and the remaining expression will be our regular expression, or you can say the required regular expression. So I guess it is not tough, not at all tough for you, right? Again, let me clear to you, in Arden's theorem what we do is we see the incoming edges to a particular state, whether it is q1, q2, q3, q4 or as many as them. We'll just note down the incoming edges to a particular state, whichever is your initial state. In this case q1 was there, so we'll just add a null to it, okay? And third thing, we need to find out regular expression only for those states which are your final state, okay? So in this case we had only one state as final state, so we find it only for q1, and we made use of q2 and q3. We just inserted the values from equation 2 and 3 into 1 to make the equation q1 as linear, and once we did that, we just simplified the expression, then we matched it with this, that is r is equals to q plus rp. And once we get the equation like that, we can just write it as r equals to q plus qp asterisk. So I just wrote that, that is our p was ba plus ab and q was null, and I just wrote it as qp asterisk, okay? And this is our required expression. So I think that now it is totally clear to you. So if you like the video, do the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching. And if you have any doubt, do share in comments and I will help you as soon as possible.